What's up, YouTube? This is Christian Brindle bringing you another Medicare-centric video here today. And today we're going to talk about what in the world does Medicare pay for and what does Medicare not pay for. Stay tuned and watch all the way to the end. You won't want to miss this. So let's first start out with what Medicare does pay for. So Medicare as a whole is broken into two sides of the spectrum as far as expenses are concerned. You have your Medicare Part A expenses, and you have your Medicare Part B expenses. So let's start out with Part A. Medicare Part A covers, most notably, the hospital. However, what most people don't realize about Medicare Part A is they don't cover everything that happens to you in the hospital. Medicare Part A will cover the hospital room, the bed, the walls, the ceiling, the floor, basically the entire hospital as a whole. However, they don't pay for anything in the hospital when it comes to the doctors you're seeing, the anesthesiologist, the IV in your arm, MRI machines, anything of that sort is not covered by Medicare Part A. Medicare Part A most notably just covers the physical hospital itself. Medicare Part A also covers things like home health care, which is like if you spend time in a skilled nursing facility, which is basically like overnight rehab. They will cover up to 100 days in a facility like that. Medicare Part A also covers hospice care. So you have hospital coverage, but only the physical hospital. You have skilled nursing, which is like overnight rehabilitation services, only up to 100 days. They cover home health care, and they also cover hospice care. Now let's talk about Medicare Part B. Medicare Part B covers an array of different things, and you could definitely make the argument that they cover a more diverse array of things than Medicare Part A does. Medicare Part B will cover all the doctors and machinery in the hospital that you're in. So A and B work together to pay for a hospital visit as a whole. Medicare Part B also covers outpatient surgeries and doctor's appointments, specialist visits, durable medical equipment, lab work, blood work, orthotics and prosthetics, mental health care, and ambulance visits. Medicare together is supposed to work together to give you medical coverage. Each side of the coin will cover different things. But there's a lot of things that a lot of other types of health insurance you'll find will cover that Medicare won't. Let's talk about them. So the first things first that Medicare doesn't pay for is most notable is prescription drug coverage. Medicare has two different sides of the equation when it comes to prescription drugs. You have your Medicare Part D as in dog drugs, and you have your Medicare Part B as in boy drugs. Medicare Part B as in boy drugs are covered under Medicare Part B. However, Medicare Part B drugs, an example of this would be a high expensive injectable medication that you get in the hospital. It's not the type of medication you can fill at a pharmacy and take on your own at home. That would be an example of a Medicare Part D as in dog drug. Part D drugs are not covered by Medicare on its own. If you want to get Part D coverage, which is basically coverage for prescriptions that you pick up at the pharmacy, you'll have to pick up a Medicare Part D plan through a private insurance company or pick up a plan like a Medicare Advantage plan that has it all wrapped into one. Medicare also doesn't pay for dental, vision, hearing coverage. They will pay for medical costs for eye exams like cataract surgery, but they won't pay for an eye exam to determine if you need a new prescription for your glasses. With Medicare, it's always based off if something is a medical cost instead of a benefit of your eye cost or a benefit of your teeth cost. However, if you get in a car accident and all your teeth get knocked out and they're all bloodified, I don't want to paint that picture for you by any stretch of the imagination, but Medicare would pay for that because that would be a medical cost at that point. You kind of see the differences. Medicare doesn't pay for cosmetic surgery, like plastic surgery. They don't pay for orthotics in your shoes. They don't typically pay that much when it comes to chiropractic care, typically just what's known as spinal manipulation, which is adjustments, but they won't pay for anything else at the chiropractor. Medicare does not cover a physical. You heard it right. You heard it here first. Medicare does not cover a physical after your first 12 months being on Medicare. So your first 12 months being on Medicare, they give you what's known as a Welcome to Medicare physical. One time. Any time period after that, being on original Medicare, whether you have a supplement or not, they will not pay for a physical. They will pay for something known as a wellness visit. And a wellness visit is basically like a less detailed physical. So when you're going to the doctor, if you have original Medicare as your primary insurance, this doesn't apply if you have a Medicare Advantage plan. Make sure you're getting a wellness visit and not a physical. It all depends on how the doctor's office bills it up. Thanks so much for watching, folks. I really, really hope you got a lot out of this video. And these are just some examples of some things that Medicare pays for and some things that Medicare does not pay for. If you found this video helpful, if you feel like you're exiting this video knowing more than you did coming in, please do us a favor and destroy that like button. Click it for me, because it helps us reach more people just like you to provide this message. Please drop a comment on what you'd like to see in future videos. Subscribe for future content. And as always, folks, if you are on Medicare and you're just not sure if you're satisfied with the program that you have, or if you're turning 65 and you're just bombarded by your choices and your options, I actually own a company called Christian Brindle Insurance Services, where we work with people just like you on their Medicare. We partner with some of the largest insurance companies in the industry, actually pretty much all of the largest insurance companies in the industry, and we sort through the options for you to find the best available program based on your specific needs and preferences. This way, you can get unbiased information. You're not in a situation where you're depending on someone to tell you the truth that works for one particular insurance company that's going to have biased information. The best part is this is completely free, no obligation, no consultation, and we give you year-round customer service. It's a great situation for you to be in. Currently, we work with people that live in the states of Utah, where our office is located, Idaho, which is right next to our state, Florida, because I lived in Florida, and coming soon, Oregon. We'll have a license in Oregon in the next week. Give us a call, folks. We're going to flash our phone number here up on the screen. We'd be happy to talk with you. No cost, no obligation. If it turns out you're on the best thing for you, we'll tell you, because the last thing we want is to make a recommendation that's not going to benefit you. Thanks for watching, and I hope you have a great, great day.